I'm joined right now by Frederick Lawrence. He's a distinguished lecturer in law at Georgetown Law and is the secretary and CEO of the Phi Beta Kappa Society, also a former prosecutor in New York, right? Lay it out for us, layman's terms. How big a deal is this that the special counsel wants to talk to the president himself?
This is a very big deal. When you reach the point in an investigation where the prosecutor and the investigators are doing the culmination of all their work, they've talked to a lot of the smaller people in what they're looking at, and now they're moving up the chain, and they've talked to members of the president's team. They're going to talk to Bannon. They've talked to Sessions. Now talking to the president, this is a very big deal. This hasn't happened since Bill Clinton, and before Bill Clinton, it hadn't happened in a lifetime.
And how will this talk take place? Will the president go in with his attorney to talk to Mueller and his team? Will there be the grand jury that's in panel, which means that his lawyers can't go with him, right?
That's right. That's exactly what's being worked out now. The president's lawyers and the lawyers on Mr. Mueller's team are right now working out what the terms are going to be. If it's more like grand jury testimony, then he can't have a lawyer with him. It doesn't matter whether he goes into the grand jury room. When President Clinton testified before the grand jury, he did it from the White House, and there were lawyers at the White House asking him questions from Ken Starr's staff, and that was actually telephonically put into the grand jury room.
Right.
No lawyers for the president at that time.
Right.
On the other hand, if this is an interview with the Mueller team, then he could have a lawyer with him. So that's what's being negotiated right now between the president's lawyers and the independent counsel.
I'm going to assume if you're the lawyer for the president, you don't want him going before a grand jury.
This is an issue I go to the mattresses on, if I can. Now, the question is, how much leverage do they have? And we don't really know the answer to that because we don't know everything that the independent counsel knows. So he knows everything he knows about what other people in the president's team have said. So he knows how much leverage he's got. But if I'm the president's lawyer, I say, of course he'll testify, and of course he'll testify under oath. But I want it to be an interview, and I want to be in the room.
Does Mr. Mueller have a subpoena with the president's name on it?
Well, he's probably got it in his pocket, but he doesn't want to have to use it for political reasons, and the president doesn't really want to be subpoenaed. So he would much rather have this be a investigation that goes forward by a conversation, if you will, an interview with the president. A lot of people have worried about whether it's under oath or not. The president said it'll be under oath, but the fact is that turns out, believe it or not, to be a smaller issue because there is also a law about false statements to a government official doing an investigation.
Right.
So perjury is under oath, but you're in violation of the False Statements Act if you make a false statement in the middle of an investigation.
Why is the president, other than his title, his job, the last person, if this is the last person, that Mueller would want to talk to?
I think it's because that's the frame of this investigation. It's leading ultimately to whether or not the president of the United States was involved in collusion with a foreign power as part of his campaign, and now whether the president of the United States was involved in obstruction of justice.
Now, the president's supporters are going to get me for this, but would you want to talk to the president if you don't have evidence or strong suspicion that there is a crime that's been committed?
I would be loath to take that step. I think he has to talk to the president to button up everything that he's got. I think there's an argument that says now he knows everything he knows and he's got the goods on the president. There's an argument for that, that those attacking the president would say that. Those defending the president would say he's just going to corroborate the rest of the story. It's very hard to predict that from the outside. But there's no way this investigation ends without talking to the president of the United States.
This has been an education. Thank you very much. Appreciate
Pleasure.
You. All right.